नमस्कार, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल हेल्दी भवो। दिस इज प्रियंका सिंह हियर अगेन। सो स्टे, होप यू ऑल एंजॉयिंग वेल, हेल्पफुली, स्टेइंग सेफ एंड एंजॉयिंग योर लाइफ ब्लिसफुली, एंड योर हेल्थ शुड बी द टॉप मोस्ट प्रायोरिटी ऑफ योर लाइफ। दैट्स व्हाई आई एम हियर टू कीप ऑन पोस्टेड विद द न्यू वीडियोज ऑफ माइंड। सो बेसिकली टुडेज सेशन ऑफ माइंड इज मोर कंसर्नड अबाउट कोर स्ट्रेंथनिंग your lower parts of the body. Mainly it will include your butt, thigh, hamstring and your calf muscles. So this way after the video you'll feel your core tightened and strengthened, your butt tone, not in single video, not in one day, but at least if you keep on trying after watching my video, and I assure you, I guarantee you that your butt would get toned, thigh, hamstring strengthened, especially the lower parts of your body, right? So without talking much, let's begin our session first with a few warm-ups. First, close your eyes. Place your legs parallel to each other. Straighten your spine. Eyes closed. Any yoga session must be started with chanting of any mantra. I start with Omkara. Open up your eyes slowly and let's begin with the warm-up. Warm-up is mandatory. Please do not skip this step. Place the right palm on your left side of the neck and stretch it towards the right side of shoulder. With exhale, inhale center, press your left side. And again, repeat. Neck towards right with exhalation. Change, relax, go with the half circle, breathe in, breathe out. Please do not skip this. Another side. It facilitates you for the further stretch and relax. Let's begin with slight arm stretch. Straighten your arms and just rotate it 30 times clockwise. Feel. Just you have to feel your palm, your arms, your biceps started burning. That's my aim. The fat, unnecessary, unessential fats must be burned out. Reverse. Same. Reverse. Try to see from the sides how the arms are working. Good fat, it must be there in our body. But bad fat must be removed, extracted from our body. Right? See, arms are burned. And relax. Shrug your shoulders up. Breathe out, down. Breathe in, breathe out, down. Relax. Now let's work on our legs. So just raise your right leg up and move it forward, backward, forward, backward. If you are not comfortable with the balancing, you can take support of the wall side. keep your left leg or the leg whichever is onto the floor locked. Left knee should be locked. Very good. Continue. Keep on smiling. One thing I forgot to tell you in the beginning, you have to maintain your spine. Smile whether you are able to work out or not. Practice makes a man perfect. Change. So keep on practicing. Do not think that you are not able to work out. You would be certainly. But ensure health always comes to you first before anything else in the world. Not even your wealth. Keep on smiling. Smiling, relax. Now once again, raise your right leg up and start. Bring your right thigh parallel to the floor. And left right leg should be dropped down. You have not to move your right calf muscle. Rather, I would be moving from the right hips girdle. Left knee again locked. See, thigh started burning. Reverse. You can take balance. Relax. Relax your right thigh. It's burning like anything. Now walk on your left leg. Bring your left foot, left thigh parallel to the floor again. Left leg, left calf muscle droop down. Again, just rotate from your hips girdle. Reverse. Continue. Do not give up. Your leg, relax your thigh muscles completely. I have not worked out much, and see, you can see the sweat I have got. Yes, your thigh muscle workout itself brings the sweat, right? So let's begin to our balancing asana tree pose. So what is the trick? I'll show you. You have to bring the right foot to the left inner thigh like this. Go slowly. First balance like this, and now you have to first come to pranayamasana. Once you are balanced, then straighten your arms up, interlock the index fingers pointed towards the ceiling, right? Right knee towards your right side, balance here. Keep on. You would feel after 10 seconds itself, your left leg would start working. Balance. Gaze at one fixed point. You would be able to balance. If you are not able to balance, you can take support of wall. Lean against the wall and then stand in this pose. Or else, even if you're not comfortable with wall side, you can place your right foot on your calf muscle as well, right? But do not press it on your knee. gaze at one fixed point and keep on your toes tucked. See the left foot, left calf muscle, left thigh, hamstring, left heel started to work. Anyone having flat foot problem can resolve with this asana, tree pose, vrikshasana. Moreover, it's good for your concentration because you are focusing on a particular point. You are gazing at a particular object. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. First, exhale with your arms down and then release your leg down. Right? So, this was all with the right leg. Now let's work out on the left side. Same, you have to first place your left foot to the right inner thigh like this. It's all about balancing game. If you're not focused, you would be hardly able to balance. First in pranam mudra, left knee towards left side, spine straight. And then straighten your arms up, interlock the finger, index finger pointing up towards the ceiling. Hold, same formula, gaze at one fixed point, choose your fixed object to gaze at, keep on smiling, it's holding your breath. Do not holding up of your posture, do not hold your breath. And with each inhalation, keep on stretching your arms up, up, up towards the ceiling. Feel as if someone is pulling your arms upward. Feel, feel, hold, posture, not breath. Another 5, 4, 3. See your right foot, right calf muscle, right thigh, hamstring, even the right butt started and it's working. And relax, arms down, legs down, leg down. And relax here completely. Your both legs have worked out well with the balance of Vrikshasana. Right? So we'll move on to another state. So this is in flow. Now next what we will do, that would be in flow. So these are the customized. I'll show you and just come walk along with me. Here we have to straighten your body. Place your palms, arms away from chest. At the back and breathe in, place your arms up, arch slightly your back, breathe in, go down, bend from the base of your spine, do not hunch your back while bending, Padhastasana, and then here jump back, see. You have to jump, palms completely onto the mat, fingers spread in uniformly to gain uniform support and jump. Go back and then here to plank, then chaturanga. Chaturanga means low dip like this. You have to bend your elbows closer to rib cage and breathe in, come up. Without touching your knee to the mat, legs flat, resting on ankle, chin up, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, upward facing dog. Hold here, then go tucking your toes, to mountain, adjust your leg so your body comes in an inverted V pose. Right? Again, roll on to plank. Right? Then chaturai, exhale, inhale, upward facing dog, exhale, fountain. Again to plank. I'm repeating this because plank is good core strength, core working. Plank used to strengthen your core. And then to chaturai, complete body workout, and it's again working on your core, your thigh, your abdomen. Then to mountain, working on your spine. Again to plank, then down, up, down, plank, down, exhale, inhale. See, notice here, my knees, thigh, legs are above the mat. Exhale, mountain, again plank. I'll do it 5 more times. Plank. Mountain. One time. Two. Plank. Down. Three. Plank, down, four, plank. This one is last round. Come on, do not give up. Up and hold here for few counts. Let's drop to table's pose. Relax in child pose and relax here. And now let's come back to table's pose. Table is on all fours, palms under shoulders, and your knee under hips, right? Let's begin cat and cow stretch to relax your spine. Breathe in, arch your back, head up, breathe out, hunch your back, chin to the chest, spine curve, breathe in, go slow to feel the relaxation. Neutral position, right? Now let's work on table pose variations. Straighten your right leg. Right leg should be in line with right hips, and stretch your left arm forward. Balance on your right palm. Again, I say your right palm, right fingers stretched completely uniformly so that the weight of the palm is getting uniformly distributed, right? Right leg back, left arm forward, and let's begin. When you inhale, arch your back and raise your right leg up like this. When you exhale, bring your elbows to your knee, chin to the chest, breathe in, Breathe out. Continue. Go slow. Arms down, relax your right shoulders by rotating it and relax. So if you feel any discomfort in your wrist during this, you just place your upper side of palm onto the mat and go forward, backward, forward, backward, then forward, backward like this. Now let's begin on our left side. Breathe in, left leg stretched outward, right arm up, forward, let's start. Breathe in, breathe out. You can relax in child pose. Relax here for a while. And come up again to table's pose. Yes. See how much I'm sweating. Yes, let me see. Yeah, I have burned 300 calorie till now. So I'm encouraged again to burn more. So let's begin on our spatial walk on table. Right? So just look at my posture. What we have to do, tuck your toe and come to the first back end of your mat. Tuck your toe, lift up your knee just an inch above the mat. Right? And walk. Yes, ensure the gap between the palms and knees are uniform throughout. One round. Bear walk. I'm enjoying this. It's working on my core badly. Yes. My core is activated completely, thigh. And relax here. Relax in child pose to relax your thigh.
Come up.
Child pose to table. Now my favorite, plank. Falakasana. See the many people get confused with the plank posture. It's pretty simple. You don't have to do anything in plank. Simply just check the posture. Palms exactly under shoulders and tables. And do not move your body. Simply straighten your right leg up without moving your knee. Straighten your right leg. Tuck your toe. And then just shift the weight onto your waist. And straighten your left leg back. See, this is plank posture. Look at 75 degree. Now let's go to plank climber. Falakasana. Breathe in. 1, 2, 3. Do not change the posture. 6, 7, 8, Done 20 times on right side. And once again, come to plank. Left side. Child pose.
Done 20 times on both legs. Total is counting of 40. Again plank. One of the effortless. Effortless means it does not hurt
any part of your body. That rather gives the maximum benefit, right? Here in plank, none of your bones got hurt, but it was working completely on your abs, right? Again, core was getting strength, and come to forearm planks. Straighten your body. Lie down first completely. Just look at the posture. You have to place your elbows just under your shoulders, closer to rib cage. Tuck your toes and lift up your body. And hold this posture. Squeeze your core. Hold. Bring a smile. Straighten your body. Last 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, drop down, relax in Makarasana. This is called Makarasana. Palms one over another, forehead resting on your palms, heels inward, legs outward. Yoga has its own relaxation pose, so it facilitates you to relax in a pose rather than you simply relax this way, that way. Rather hold and relax in a yogic pose, right? So this is the added advantage of doing yoga. Once again, come up on table, pressing the palms, and come up on table. Now here, bring your left foot forward in between palms like this and tuck your right toe, turn your heel, lift up your right knee, left foot forward, right foot inclined inward, come up, straighten your body, straighten your legs, right? We have come to standing pose. I'll show you the warrior one. It will again burn your thigh, right? So I told you in the beginning of the session, today's workout is mainly on core and workout on the lower part. So let's start. Straighten your arms with breathing. Bend your left leg, left thigh parallel to the floor. If it's not working, it's hurting your knee, you can slightly bend it at 75. But the ultimate perfect is parallel to your floor. Do not cross your knee to the ankle. It might hurt, damage your knee. So always parallel. If it's not going parallel, bring more gap. Hold. Two. Smile. Warrior one. Hold. Do not give up. Come up. Slowly relax your left thigh. See how it started burning. right? I feel the pleasure when I feel the fats burnt out, right? You have to go and at least feel some pain to gain, right? Again, right thigh parallel to the floor. Breathe in, arms up. Let's begin. There is no gain without pain. If you really want toned thigh, toned butt, strengthened core, do work along with my video. It's customized for these requirements. Your left knee slowly, bring your right leg back and lie down on your stomach completely. Yes, I have lied down. Let me wipe off my sweat. Now here, let's move on to our next asana, that is Bhujangasana. Again, beneficial for your back, lower back, and your lungs as well. So place the palms beside your chest and wait. Just give me a second. And palms beside chest, elbows closer to ribcage. So these are the instruction necessary things. So you please keep on in your mind. Don't go away from the instruction. Your elbows should be closer to ribcage, should be outward, right? Palms beside your chest. Come up with breathing. Elbows bend, raise up to your navel. Stretch your back, arching your legs folded. Bring your soul closer to head. Go down. Legs down. Breathe in. Up. Breathe out. Continue. Continue. Facilitates, gives your better back bending. And last one, hold here, 10, smile. And drop down, relax in Makarasana. Another variation of Makarasana, palms on either side of face, cheek resting on one side, legs folded on the cheek resting side, eyes closed. Now come up slowly from Makarasana and turn on your spine. If you have crocodile clip clutcher, please do take out. It will hurt your skull. Right? And now bend your knees. Place the palms beside your body. If you are comfortable, catch hold of your ankles the way I hold. So bend your knee. Once again, I instruct. Do not need to look at my picture. Just listen the instruction. Instructions are quite precise and clear. So catch hold of your knee. Knees bend. heels closer to hips and raise your butt up first with breathe in. If you are not comfortable in catching your ankles, you can press your palms down or clasp your palms down under your hips. Your choice. Right? Breathe in, lift up your hips first, then waist, then your chest, and body resting on shoulders. Completely body up, hold. And now pulse up and down. Do not touch the hips to the mat. One. Activate your core. And hold here for a while, 10 counts. Drop down your chest first with exhale, then waist, then hips, and knees still bent. Straighten your arms at the sides. And drop your knees to the left side, placing kneecap one over another, and look onto your right shoulder. Ensure the shoulders are still grounded. Breathe in up, breathe out, another side, again kneecap one over another, shoulders are still grounded. Come up. Onto your left side, hold, hold means you have to keep on twisting your spine, feel the stretch on your sides, arms still grounded, do not lift up your shoulders in order to stretch and drop down knees. If your knees not dropping down, no issue, that's okay, but arms, shoulders grounded, inhale, hold on to your right side. Come up and relax completely. See, today's session I have covered everything, beginning from core strengthening to thigh to hamstring to calf muscle. That was all in today's session, and now any session is not complete without your abs workout, right? So we'll begin. Simpler abs workout, the Uttan Padasana. Place your palms under your hips and raise your legs at 90 degree. Tighten your kneecap. Kneecap must be straightened and tightened. Toes active. As soon you make your toes active, you feel you start the pressure on your core intensified by raising your head up. If you have more belly fat, do this for 5 minutes every day. It will certainly burn. In this video, I can't show you for longer stretch. Another 20. Drop down your head first, bend knee, relax your legs, straighten your legs completely and lie down in Shavasana, corpse pose. Follow the basic rules of Shavasana, legs apart, toes falling freely out, arms away from your body, should be slightly away, not so far, not too close, slightly away from body, nose pointing towards ceiling, eyes closed. Again, like warm up, do not miss the shavasana as well to relax your complete stretch body parts. Whatever you have worked out, it needs to get closed with relaxation. Stay and lie here in this pose without movement of any parts. Feel as if there is no life, like dead body. So called corpse pose, Shavasana. And start rotating your awareness from top of the head. Feel your crown relax, eyebrow center relax, forehead relax, cheek relaxed, chin relaxed, lips relaxed, eyes relaxed, ears relaxed, complete face relaxed, throat center relaxed, back of the throat relaxed, shoulders relaxed, shoulder blades relaxed, back of the shoulders relaxed, arms relaxed, upper arms relaxed, inner arms relaxed, armpit relaxed, elbows relaxed, forearm relaxed, palms relaxed, fingers relaxed, tip of the fingers relax, sides of your torso relaxed, chest center relax, back of the chest, that is upper part of your back, relaxed, diaphragm, the area below lungs and above abdomen relaxed, back of diaphragm, middle back relaxed, front fossa, navel region relax, back, lower back relax, waist relaxed, thigh relaxed, hamstrings relaxed, hips relaxed, knees relaxed, shin bone relaxed, calf muscles relaxed, ankles relaxed, feet relaxed, toes relaxed, tip of the toes relaxed, all 10 toes relaxed, sole relaxed, heels relaxed. Again, roam around towards your center of head. So it's ascend, calf muscle relaxed, back of the knee relaxed, hamstring relaxed, hips relaxed, waist relaxed, waistline relaxed, vertebrae relaxed. Go slowly up, up, up towards the neck. Ascend your awareness slowly, slowly towards your neck, covering the parts of your back, and reach the back of neck, that is nape, relaxed. Ascend up to reach your skull, relax. Once again, reach your crown of the head, the source of thousands of energy, where Sahasrara Chakra lies. Relaxed. completely. Feel the calmness, numbness of your body. Feel heaviness of your body. Now time to come out of Yog Nidra. Wiggle your fingers and toes. Turn on to the right side of your mat. Place the left palm in front of your chest to take the support. And take your time. After intense workout, your body relaxed in Shavasana doesn't tend to come up, so take your time. Once taken, relaxed, come up with the support of left palm. Sit in Sukhasana. This is Sukhasana, easy pose. Spine straight and elongated. And let's conclude our session. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Rub your palms together enough to generate warmth. Place it on eye, cheeks, all across your body to feel the warmth, and open up your eyes with gentle smile on your face. That's all for today's session. Thank you so much for viewing my video, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel Healthy Bhava and press the bell icon once you have watched the video. Thank you so much once again. And ensure once whatever videos I have shown, whatever the workout I have done, keep on working the same way. Keep on intact with the video. Keep on intact with the instruction. Do not go away from the instruction. Thank you so much once again.
हो गया।